Hello everyone, this is Viren and welcome to the fantasy match preview for the game between Punjab and Chennai. Before the preview, do keep in mind to join the free giveaway that you have, and there'll also be another free giveaway code that I'll mention at the end of this video, so do keep in mind. Apart from that, remember to also join the Fan2Play leaderboard where the top 3 winners go to Australia to watch the T20 World Cup Finals. So don't miss out on that chance, and apart from that, you also have a lot of cash prizes on offer. Today, Crick Crazy Nicks, like we all know him, Nikhil, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Pleasure to be back with the Fan2Play fam. Yes.
How is it going? How are the safe picks going finally for you?
They're going good at last. Hopefully, it remains the same without cooking the mockers on myself. Yeah.
So let's get to the team for today then. So I think you and me, I have a gut feeling that you and me might have some disagreements in a few sections.
Okay.
But chalo, we'll start with the most obvious one,
okay.
The keepers. So Matthew Wade or Gurbaz, whoever plays according to me. Any initial thoughts here?
No, I don't think so. I think both of them, anyone who plays, if you really want to go massive, take Dhoni if he's batting first. Because I think his batting will come versus the bowling that Gujarat have. They have a good side, good bowling side, and
very good.
You
bowling,
could get. There will be Rashid's trouble because Rashid has had poor time against Chennai, but that was because of Shane Watson. But now that him not being there, it will be different. So yeah, differential pick there, Dhoni. But yes, safe pick is whoever plays between Wade and Gurbaz.
True. So for now, we'll probably keep Wade because we're assuming he played in the last game too.
Yeah.
Okay. Apart from that, then onto the batsman. I think first pick will be Shubman Gill.
Yeah,
I think he's the most non-polar choice from this batting section, the most stable choice.
Yes.
And probably because Chennai's bowling, pace bowling attack is not as strong, he might get away at the start too.
Possibly.
And possibly. Apart from that, who do you see as your other batsman for this game?
I think Robin Athappa makes for a good choice because he's been from looking in good touch, making right decisions on the crease. So, not taking too many risks, so I feel that's a good thing to have for fantasy, especially in batting section. And given that Fan2Play allows only two batters, you could just go with Gill and Athappa. But I feel there are two options here who could be, if Chennai are to win, these two have to do well, and that is Ambati Raidu, because I think he'll be very, very critical to counter Rashid. He's played him well before. And Dubeji, I'm just really thankful that CSK are finding a way to use Shivam very well. He's somebody, he's brought in to hit runs, to 100 runs versus spin. So I'm very keen to see what are the bowlers that Gujarat bowl to him, because I'm sure they're not going to bowl him anything junk or something like that. They'll get to Rashid or maybe Lockie only directly. That could be a very interesting matchup. Definite choice there. But for now, I think Raidu is a slightly safer choice if you want to go down.
Especially
there.
Because of how he's played Rashid in the past.
Yeah, purely based on that.
But how do you see Uttappa and Dubey both matching up to the high pace of Lockie? Do you feel like they can be rattled by him, especially at Pune with the pace, with the bounce?
So it can work both ways. Like we've seen two faces of Lockie as well. In one game, he was all over the place, and the other, he got it spot on. So if you go by that pattern, this should be an all over the place game. So if you go by that pattern, then I think you can take more middle order players of Chennai, because if you feel, because Lockie is bowling one in the power play and then he's bowling directly at the end. So you could take those middle overs players, which is why I've gone with Raidu. So you can pick maybe both Raidu and Dubey. I think Jadeja also will play a key role now, because he doesn't like to hit spin, but he doesn't mind going after pace. So I think the batting order will be very crucial for Chennai to counter Lockie.
Right. Okay, so I think we go with three batters for now, Raidu, Gill and Uttappa. So now we have the all-rounders for today. I think the first few picks are quite obvious, Hardik and Jadeja. Any different thoughts there?
Yeah, unless you want to take Vijay Shankar, I think can come good sometime soon.
In reverse fantasy, I would take him.
no disrespect there, sorry. Just being very honest in terms of fantasy returns, it's a very difficult thing to take a guy who hasn't been scoring runs, but great mini Grand League pick. That would be very, very left field. And if he comes good, you are going to top the Grand League. So,
and he's playing against his homeland. So,
exactly. So, do not rule that out. Teams have found ways, different inspirations. So, yeah, But yes, Hardik Pandya and Ravindra Jadeja are common choices. Mohinadi also will get into my side purely because he's been looking well, getting some runs now, and hopefully he'll be used more with the ball. So that way he can give you points from all three games, all three parts of the game.
Right, so you see him bowling more in this game with, like, after he opened the bowling in the last game?
Definitely. It will depend a lot on matchups. I don't think Dhoni believe too much in them, but I'm sure Jadeja and Fleming do. So even if MS is the unofficial captain, I still see that happening.
Okay. Okay, then we are on to the bowlers. I think the first pick is Rashid Khan. Apart from that, who else do you see making this team for us?
Yes, as you said, Rashid is a no-brainer. I think same is the case with Lockie, with his ability to really bounce people out. And Chennai do have a few who can be troubled with that extra pace. It could very well work in their favour as well if he doesn't hit his lines. So, but I still think Lockie is a good guy to take. He'll get you one or two wickets because he bowls in those parts of the game where wickets are likely to fall. So I think Rashid, Lockie, and I think Manish Tikshana definitely walks into my side. Someone like him, if he can get Gill or Hardik early in the power play, that could really set the game up for Chennai. So I'll go with these three. And obviously the bowling first option remain in Shami if Lucknow bowl first. And if Chennai are bowl first, I'm sure Dwayne Bravo will be there. Yeah.
And apart from that, two questions for you. First thing is, do you see Tikshana being played out by Gill and Pandya like they played out Chahal defensively, or do you see them taking an attacking option against him?
I think it depends on how the other guys are going. Say if somebody like Mukesh Chaudhary is not allowing runs to go, then they'll want one of them will definitely take on Mahesh Tikshana, and that's where there is a chance for Mahesh to strike gold. Like he got Faf out in the previous game. He can definitely do that. And because they haven't faced him before, I do think they will be cautious. But then if you're naturally aggressive and you're playing cautiously, there is still a chance for the bowler to sneak through. So I think that will be the contest, because both teams depend a lot on power play. So how the power play goes for both sides is definitely going to set the tone for them.
Great. And apart from that, the other question is on Lockie Ferguson. Do you see his pace troubling Dubey and Uttapa? And apart from that, do you feel he'll have some ex-home advantage with rising Pune Super Giants having played here quite a bit?
Knowing the conditions should definitely help, at least. And see, as we said, the thing with pace is you could have days like Lockie had. One day Lockie was perfectly fine, and then he had a very off day, and then he's had a good day. So maybe this is the off day, who knows? So it's a hit or miss, but I still think that you can be smart about countering him. Take him on only if the situation is asking you to, because you have to see Gujarat have good bowlers, but you can work around them. There is a Yash Dayal, there is a Darshan Nalkhande if he plays. So Rahul Tavatia, whenever he has bowled, I think he has got hit for runs as well. So that is, it has to do with the way the plans are at that point and what is your situation. And good bowling will always trouble anyone, be it a junior, senior, anyone. So I think I'll not read too much into it, because if you're coming off good runs, it helps you counter that bowling better as well. So let's see how that goes.
Makes sense. And apart from that, who do you see as captain, vice captain, apart from Hardik or Gill being the obvious choices?
Yeah, I think Hardik and Gill will most probably end up being the safest options. Jadeja, Moin could be a handy, one of them could be a handy option if Chennai are batting first, and if you feel there won't be much damage with the new ball, like if they can play Shami out, because you do think probably Gaikwad will get out, hopefully not. But again, that's a grand league option that people can try, because there one game Gaikwad will come good. He's too good a player to be missing out. And there will be some days, some game where he'll get a lot of bad balls at the start and then he just gets in. So I think for now in the small leagues, it is probably sound and safe to go with Hardik and even say a Rashid Khan. Rashid Khan is due for a 3-4. And this is a side against whom he's had troubles, but they also take him on. So that could be a very interesting option to try out. especially if he's bowling second, and if the if there isn't much dew, then it could be a very good
game. Pune, actually, that is a good point. Yeah. That the dew doesn't play much of a part because of the high altitude. And apart from that, that would also mean that Ali and Jadeja would become good second inning bowling choices too.
That's the idea.
The matchup will come out then finally between Rashid and Ali. Do you feel like, because he's dismissed him thrice, but on the same end, Ali really goes after him just like Raidu. So how do you feel that will go, and how do you feel Rashid's numbers are getting skewed with Watson not being there?
Yeah, so it is a very interesting thing. I actually pulled up his numbers year-wise against Chennai. And if you look at it, in the last year, he's taken them 4 wickets for them in 2 games. So if that data is correct, so that is an interesting sense. His economy of is over 7.5, which is not something that you usually associate with Rashid. So he has been hit around for fun, because I think Chennai uses sweep very well. Shane Watson sits down and just slogs and just murders the that kind of bowling, and something Raidu does that as well. So I think that is something that is going to be very critical, because Chennai have 4 players now in the middle overs who can really go after the spin bowling. Uthappa isn't that great with leg spin at times, but he can hit anything if you bowl bad to him. But there is Mohin Ali, there is Shivam Dubey. People will have their own opinions about that, but there is spin bowling. So,
but he'll pick them on the ground and sweep them. That is one factor.
And that is what could make this very interesting. That, you know, if Rashid gives him something length kind of to it, then he can
take it.
So I think it's going to be very interesting to see how do these players, Dubey, Mohin Ali, Ambati Raidu. So these are 3 guys who can really go after the bowling if there is a stable partner at the other end. And then you can obviously always use a Jadeja or a Bravo as well to just come in and hit. Because I think that is something we haven't seen yet from Chennai, but I don't think it's too far. We'll see that soon.
That who do you feel are your challenge picks for this game, and how many in that regard?
Challenge picks, I think, are the best places to go safe at times. So I will go with Hardik Gill, and the third pick could be between Jadeja or maybe a Dwayne Pretorius or a Dwayne Bravo, purely because if I feel that there's some based on the toss. But Hardik and Gill will definitely be there. Because I think they have been doing the bulk of the job. From Chennai, it probably be Jadeja, or because I don't think Uthappa Dubey can be that reliable to consistently score. Runs. It's not practically possible to do that. But so I'll probably go with an out-order only, maybe one of Mohin or Jadeja as the third pick.
Makes sense. And I hope you've joined the giveaway already.
Yes.
If you haven't, the code is SUNFCP, and for all of you as well, the code is SUNFCP. Please go ahead and join the giveaway and join the free entry too. So I guess we have it all from Nikhil then. Thank you so much for joining us. Any closing comments from you, any suggestions, anything of that sort?
Just do try Shivam Dubey. I'll continue to say that he's being used very well. It's not that you don't want him to score a 90 every game, but with the bowling that Gujarat have, that is their strongest suit. And for Chennai to come good, it has to be one of him or Gaikwad to really, really come off. And if Gaikwad doesn't come off, then Chennai will find it hard to stay in this tournament for a long period of time. So one of those Chennai all-rounders, because Shivam will start to bowl as well at some point of time. So if Chennai bowl first, I think they have a better chance. Because if Gujarat bowl first, they have too good a bowling attack. So I think let's see how it goes at the toss, and then what are the conditions in Pune.
Great. Makes sense. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us, Nikhil. And it's a pleasure having you, like always.
Thank you so much for having me. Happy meetings.